finding square root of a number by prime factorization. Hello friends, in this video we will learn to find the square root using the prime factorization method. Friends, there are some perfect squares on the screen. Can you find the square roots of these numbers? If the square of 4 is 16, then we can say that the square root of 16 is 4. Similarly, the square of 5 is 25. So we can say that the square root of 25 is 5. So tell me, if the square of 7 is 49, then what will be the square root of 49? Absolutely right. The square root of 49 will be 7. Similarly, can you find the square root of the number 729? It is not essential that we must always remember the square root of all perfect squares. This is because we can find the square root of any number using different methods. So, let us find the square root of 729 using the prime factorization method. As per the name of this method, we can guess that we have to do the prime factorization of the number. In this method, we divide the number by prime numbers until we get a prime number or 1. For this, we will draw a figure similar to the one on the screen. In the second column of the top row, we will write the number that we wish to factorize. Now, let's get started. Find the smallest prime number that divides 729 completely. That is 3. Write 3 in the first column of the first line. Dividing 729 by 3 gives us 243. Write it below 729. Now find the smallest prime number that divides 243 completely. That is 3. Write 3 in the first column of the second line. Dividing 243 by 3 gives 81. Write it below 243. Now find the smallest prime number that divides 81 completely. That is 3. Write 3 in the first column of the third line. Dividing 81 by 3 gives the result 27. Write it below 81. 27 is not a prime number. 3 is the prime factor of 27. Write it in its designated place. Dividing 27 by 3 gives us 9. Write 9 under 27. We know that the square of 3 is equal to 9. So, we will write 3 in the first column of the fifth row and also under 9. Now, we get the number 3 in the last row of the second column, which is a prime number which has only two factors, the numbers 1 and 3, which we mark like this. All the prime factors of the number 729 are written in the first column. And number 1 is the remainder in the last row of the second column, indicating that the process is over. We can write the number 729 as the product of its prime factors. Now we will see how many prime numbers are in pairs in this factorization. There are 3 pairs of number 3. By the laws of exponents, we can write this multiplication of factors as, we get 729 as the square of 27. That is, we can say that the square root of 729 is 27. Thus, here we get the square root of the number 729. Is 432 a perfect square? If you think it is a perfect square, then find its square root using the prime factorization method And if not, find the number which can be used to divide 432 such that we get a perfect square. You can pause the video here and factorize this number. We know that if a number is a perfect square, it is equal to the square of its square root. Now let us depict the number 432 as a product of its prime factors. We can see that not all prime factors of this number are in pairs here. That is, it is not a perfect square. There is no pair of 3 here. So, if we divide the number 432 by 3, we will get the number 144, which is a perfect square. Its square root is 12. So, we learned to find the square root by the prime factorization method and have seen examples related to it. See you in the next video with some more examples related to it. Thank you. Finding square root of a number by prime factorization. Illustrative examples. Hello friends. In this video, we will see some examples of finding the square root by the prime factorization method. Find the square root of the number 3969 using the prime factorization method. In the prime factorization method, we will first do the prime factorization of the number 3969. And we will know all its prime factors this way. Now we will express the number 3969 as the product of its prime factors. After this, we will group the prime factors into pairs in this way. Then, we will take one factor out of each pair and multiply them. This product is the square root of that number. That is, the number 63 is the square root of the number 3969. Let us see another example. Find the smallest perfect square, which is completely divisible by 2, 16 and 19. If we had to find only a number that was divisible by these three numbers, then we would have to find the LCM of these three numbers. Thus, we would have received the number 304. The number 304 is not a perfect square, but here we need a perfect square. We know that all prime factors in the perfect square come in pairs. In prime factorization of the number 304, only number 19 is not in a pair. If we multiply both sides by 19, we get the number 5776 on the left-hand side, which is a perfect square. We can also see its prime factors on the right-hand side, where we will find all its prime factors in pairs. Therefore, the number 5776 is the smallest perfect square, which is divisible by 2, 16 and 19. We can also see that the square root of the number 5776 is 76. In this video, we have seen some examples of finding the square root using the prime factorization method. Hope you have understood this method very well. Thank you.